The thing to focus on is that the EBITDA went shooting up to 68%, and the net profit is up by 9-10%. Though the turnover was lower, so that shows that the type of business we're doing is more profitable. So, and if you look at it, 2011 versus 2000 quarter on quarter, it's also higher up, and we're quite pleased with it for a first quarter of a full year. We'll be buying a lot more vessels. Indeed, we announced four new purchases in the last couple of weeks. So you'll probably hear more of the same, more buying, more building of these vessels, because that's we're at capacity, basically. On the installation side, we announced this huge job in Russia, and we believe there'll be more of that coming through. And of course, the new segment, the oil field services, we're tendering in Malaysia, and we've got four prospects, and hopefully one of them will come through. So those are the kind of prospects. The general industry is quite bullish, as you know. The environment we're in is quite positive, notwithstanding the issues in Europe. Of course, the sovereign debt is a big cloud over everybody's head. So notwithstanding that, we keep an eye on it. The Caspian is a lake, and if you did your reviews, you'll find that there's only two derrick lay barges. One is owned by the Azeris, the other one is owned by us. So theoretically, I've got access to 50% of the market, so I expect to get more. The contract value, I think it was announced, was more than 200 million, and we've since then got more variations to it, so it's increasing as we speak. We do mainly the procurement and the installation of these vessels. I think a total of, if I remember well, about 90 kilometers of pipe. It's over two installation seasons. It will add directly to the bottom line this year. It will have a positive impact this year. Asia Pacific, to start with, is quite competitive. You probably know that anyway. It's a lot of newcomers into the sectors. As you know, it's the fastest growing region. There's a lot of investment. It's a young, dynamic workforce. It's a great place to be, but it's also a highly competitive place. So we see opportunities, and we need to be more selective because we don't want to compete on price. We want to compete on competency and differentiate ourselves. In Malaysia, it's more the brown fields and the marginal fields, chasing the last drop of oil. So it's quite exciting because it's technology based. So you need a lot of technologies to come through. We feel that Bumi is well positioned because we are architects of technology. Well, the attractiveness of the Bumi Armada today is actually reflected in a lot of the analysts worldwide. I mean, we are the largest by market cap in the segment. And the reason for that is our delivery model and our business model. Our delivery model is quite reliable. We are able to deliver major projects without destroying value, and that kind of differentiates us from the pack. Number two is our business model has got the FPSOs plus the OSVs and the T&I, so it gives me a blended EBITDA that is amongst the highest in the world, actually. We're right there in the top 3-5 from a blended EBITDA, which is more than, on average, more than 50%, which is quite attractive. So if you are looking for investment, I think you got the best of both worlds in Bumi Armada. Africa is a big focus for us. Now, everybody talks about Latin America and, of course, the Asia, but the silent revolution that's taking place is actually in Africa. We're there, we're well established, we know how to work in Africa, we've been successful in difficult places like Nigeria, for example. So we believe we're well positioned to take advantage of the African revolution. Take a look at Mozambique, take a look at Kenya, don't forget Angola. I mean, it's a lot of excitement happening out there. And, it seems to be not everybody's cup of tea, but it is for Bumi, and we're quite keen to continue that way.